Okay, guys, before we get into the video, I have to mention that, holy cow, we have over 500 subscribers already. This is amazing. Thank you so much for all of you guys who have subscribed. It seriously means a ton. The best way you can support me and support this channel is to literally just subscribe. So if you haven't already subscribed, please do so. Go hit the subscribe button. It would mean a ton to me and it really would help the channel out. And for those of you who have already subscribed, seriously, thank you so much. Okay, let's jump in. You might see this video and think to yourself, why Triumph, a British motorcycle company focusing primarily on retro bikes? How could that have anything in common with a boutique Italian company making super and hyper motorcycles? Well, first of all, these companies have quite a bit more in common in terms of their range than you would think at first. The biggest area of overlap, of course, is in their development and use of three-cylinder engines over the past 15 years. Both companies have rebuilt their brands, at least in part because of this setup, and comparing the companies to me really is interesting. I would actually say that Triumph and MV have more in common, and there's certainly more to talk about than, for example, Triumph and Royal Enfield. We can make a video discussing these modern classics at some point, but as a whole, these are the companies for me to compare. So sit back, grab a cup of something yummy, maybe a nice cold English cider, or maybe a strong Americano, because apparently those came from Italy. Either way, let's talk about motorcycles. As with the first video in this series where we compared MV Agusta and Ducati, we're going to use these criteria: performance, styling, options, and price. And as with the other video, of course, there's more to the picture than just what we're talking about in this video, especially things like service and support, which I'll just say from the outset, Triumph is probably going to win, just like any manufacturer is probably going to beat a small company in Italy producing 5,000 motorcycles a year. If MV's promises are all true, it could be that they would actually offer sort of a less corporate experience. I actually think that should be their angle when it comes to support. Support and service is kind of off the table. And we're going to be covering these segments: street naked, hyper naked, and retro sport. Now, I'm doing a bit of work to fit these bikes into these segments that, you know, they may not totally belong in, but that's okay. This is the easiest way to compare what the brands have to offer without skipping over too many bikes. I was going to do a touring section, but MV's touring is just so different than what Triumph is offering, so it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense. And then obviously the modern classics aren't really comparable with anything that MV Agusta has to offer. So without any more, let's dive in. First, we have the Street Naked lineup, and for this, I'm focusing on Triumph's Trident, Street Triple and Regular Speed Triple, and Regular Speed Triple RS. We'll talk about the Speed Triple 1200s a bit later, and we're going to be putting this lineup of three-cylinder naked bikes up against MV Agusta's Brutale and Dragster, also three-cylinder bikes. Now, in terms of performance and specifically power, Triumph ranges all the way from the Trident, which produces 80 horsepower, up to 150 horsepower from the Speed Triple RS. There's a big range of engine sizes here as well, whereas the Brutale and Dragster lineup ranges from like 110 horsepower at the lowest end with their Rosso versions all the way up to 150 horsepower with the Dragster RC SCS version. Now, I would say that the biggest thing to point out is the way that these bikes make their power and the way that they feel and like their power band. Triumphs are incredibly fast, but they're known for being smooth, like a well-blended smoothie. Though MVs have certainly, you know, rounded out their torque curves, it's still pretty well known that they are a bit manic. MV Agustas, all the way across the range, are rowdy, they're torquey, and they're just a bit more sort of wild and unpredictable. I would say in many ways they are more performance-oriented or sort of track-oriented. They produce their power higher in the rev range and are much more like sport bikes in terms of their character. Triumph's triple range, and especially the street triples, are made for the road through and through. At the highest end, if you faced off the Speed Triple RS in this category, that is the 1050 engine that produces 150 horsepower, and you had it face off against the Dragster RC SCS, the Dragster would probably win as it weighs a shocking 30 kilograms lighter or 66 pounds less. Though both brands are known specifically for their ability to make a wonderful chassis for cornering, MV would probably still win in terms of performance in this area as well, with their long history of racing and just building track or oriented machines. For performance, I'm going to give it to MV Agusta here, even though again, it's all about what you want. Maybe you want a bike that performs a bit more predictably or comfortably, that's totally fine, and in that case, you should go with the Triumph. But even if you pitted smaller size or even like smaller horsepower producing bikes from this lineup up against each other, the MV Agusta wins every time. And you have to remember, we're talking about an 800cc bike versus, you know, a bike that's over 1,000cc's, and it's still faster, which is pretty remarkable. But again, that gets at the way these bikes perform. An 800cc bike producing the same power or more power than a 1,000cc bike is going to be a bit more nutty because the torque curve and power curve is going to just be more reasonable on that 1,000cc. It's a bit more sort of detuned, and that's definitely the case here. And then of course, the Trident is not going to perform at a level that anything that MV Agusta is offering, and that's fine. That makes, you know, the Trident a better sort of option for a lot of people, but we'll talk about that in a bit. In terms of styling, as always, this is thoroughly preferential, but I'm going to give it to MV for me. Both of these bikes are thoroughly polarizing. They're very striking motorcycles. Some people love the Street Triples. They're a bit more of that sort of Street Fighter aesthetic. They kind of made that aesthetic, honestly. And maybe those people would hate the Dragster and the Brutale, and that's totally fine. I'm just giving my take when it comes to these things. If you like the style of the Street and Speed Triples more, then for you, Triumph wins in this category and you can move on. Now, we are forgetting the Trident at this point, and that's another element of style completely different than the Street Triple. And I would take the Brutale or Dragster over the Trident personally, but it is certainly more retro, and in some ways I like the Trident style almost more than the Street Triples. I don't know, it's just more laid back, stripped down, and just simple in terms of styling. But yeah, MV wins here for me. Oh yeah, I forgot, the single-sided swing arm, the exhaust, like there's so many reasons why MV wins, but you know, I just think they're better looking bikes. Now for options in this segment, I think Triumph actually wins. Again, having the Trident as a smaller, sort of more beginner friendly option, Triumph really did something amazing with that bike in that they made an entry into sort of the lineup for people. It's like an entry bike. I believe MV is working on the same sort of thing. I think they're working on a 500cc triple or something, but for now Triumph wins for options primarily because of that Trident option. Triumph would also win in the fact that it has all sorts of different things, like little customizations you can make to your bike and ways that you configure it. It's just more like customizable, if that's a word, than the Brutale and the Dragster. The MVs here do come more spec'd up, so that's a factor. All of them have quick shifters, for example. And the newer models have a much more advanced electronic package. They come ready to be used. There's nothing you need to do to them. The exhaust already looks awesome. You know, they're kind of just sort of final products. But yeah, if you are a person who wants like a lot of options, I would say that Triumph probably does win in this segment. Okay, last but certainly not least for this section, we have price. You won't be shocked to find out that Triumph wins here by quite a lot, with their $8,000 Trident on the low end, which is obviously not really comparable in terms of what you're getting out of the MV Agustas, but it is an affordable bike to, you know, even their higher end bikes. All of Triumph's bikes are cheaper. The fastest bike in this segment, the Dragster RC SCS, will run you over 26 grand, whereas the Speed Triple RS is only 16.5, and they produce almost the same horsepower. You know, it's tough to compare these two bikes, obviously, as the SCS is faster and lighter and has more tech and is just a more sort of all-around advanced motorcycle. But across the range, you're probably going to find more real-world value in the Triumphs for what you're spending. So for this section on Street Nakeds, MV wins on performance and styling. Triumph wins when it comes to options and pricing. So it boils down to what really matters for you, but let's call it a tie for now. The next segment I want to look at is what I'm calling hyper naked, and though it's difficult to fit the Triumph Speed Triple 1200 range into any segment in like all of motorcycling, it's sort of its own segment. I think hyper naked probably makes the most sense. It is a street fighter, like MV's current four-cylinder range, and it fits nicely with these bikes as well as bikes like the Ducati Street Fighter. So let's see how it matches up. So for this segment, we have the Triumph Speed Triple 1200 RS, and we have that versus MV Agusta's Rush 1000 and Brutale 1000 RR, and now the Brutale 1000 RS, which is sort of a new release from MV. So let's start with performance. Triumph Speed Triple 1200 is probably the fastest three-cylinder motorcycle in the world. It's not the largest or the most torquey, as that goes to Triumph's Rocket 3, but it really does stand out as a unique motorcycle for what it is. Now, MV Agusta's current four-cylinder bikes, the Rush and the Brutale 1000s, are arguably the fastest, most powerful naked motorcycles in the world. They are the highest performing street fighters, or whatever you want to call them. They all produce 208 horsepower, whereas the Speed Triple produces 177 horsepower. So if you boil down performance simply to speed and power, the MV Agustas win easily, and it's true that in this segment of motorcycles, that is what you want. You want those crazy numbers, and that's why it is hard to put the Speed Triple in this category. It's sort of like in between a regular street naked and like a hyper naked, or you know, a hyper street fighter or whatever. Again, I would say the general consensus is that the Speed Triple is going to be less manic. It's a predictable, smooth, yet unbelievably powerful bike. It's great for track and for street, whereas the Brutale 1000 and the Rush are just like monster bikes. Many have reported that because the power is created so much later with these four-cylinder bikes, it actually makes them quite rideable and predictable around town and like on B roads, because you're not in that power range in the low revs. They're not twitchy, apparently. They're not difficult to manage. And I've heard the Street Fighter's the same way by Ducati. Like, it's really an easy bike to ride for what it is, for being, you know, a 200 plus horsepower motorcycle. But yeah, performance is gonna have to go to MV on this one. These are some of the highest performing motorcycles in the world. Now, styling is really tough for me. I would love to hear what you guys think down below. Which of these do you like? The Brutale, the Rush, or the Speed Triple? The Brutale 1000 RR was actually voted most beautiful motorcycle at EICMA for 2 years, I believe. And though it's incredibly aggressive and striking, I struggle to use the word beautiful. Many of MV's bikes are beautiful. The F3, for example, that's a really beautiful bike. The old F4 was a beautiful bike. Of course, the Superveloce is a beautiful bike. This bike isn't beautiful to me, and neither is the Speed Triple, honestly. I think I'm gonna give it a tie here. Personally, neither of these bikes are really my cup of tea in terms of styling, but I don't know, they look the part for sure. They're incredibly aggressive, and I don't know, I think it's a tie. Now for options, I think the MV actually wins, especially now that they have the Brutale 1000 RS, the lower spec version that comes in a few different colors. Between all of them, you have 6 color options and 2 completely different styled bikes between the Brutale and the Rush. Now again, you can spec up the Speed Triple more than you can the MVs, but there's only 2 paint options and just this one style. Now all this would be moot if you included the Speed Triple RR, which is fair, but I'm actually keeping that in a separate section and we'll talk about it in a bit, but that is sort of another option in this segment. Okay, in terms of price, I'm just gonna say it. The Triumphs are way cheaper. Yes, you're getting less, but it's just true that these hyper nakeds from MV Agusta are some of the most expensive motorcycles in the world. I was really happy to see them come out with the Brutale 1000 RS. I think that's the right move, which is much more affordable and it doesn't have any decrease in power. But to me, Triumph will win on price in literally every category just because it's not making the same kind of product and they're not made in the same way. MV Agustas are hand-built, they're almost like custom motorcycles, and like they're signed by the single person who assembles them, which I think is really cool. They produce like 5,000 motorcycles a year. Of course they're gonna be expensive. But yeah, for this segment, I've got MV Agusta winning overall just for the hyper nakeds. Again, it's all up to your preferences, and yeah, you have to have the money for it. But if you do have the money, or if you wanna save for a bit, this could be the coolest bike you'll ever purchase. It'll definitely be the coolest bike you ever purchase. But the Speed Triple is an amazing option as well. So it's close, but I think the MV Agusta wins here. All right, for this last section, we are pitting the retro-styled Speed Triple 1200 RR versus the MV Agusta Superveloce. These are two similarly styled, sort of retro-esque sport bikes, and I think it makes at least some sense to compare them, even if they're really not exactly in the same segment. So for MV, we have the Superveloce, which is basically a different body on top of their F3 Supersport platform. It has the same 800cc engine, producing 147 horsepower, which is no slouch for an 800cc bike. The Speed Triple RR is, in terms of performance, similar to the Speed Triple 1200 RS, a bit more horsepower actually, and a little bit more torque, and it pretty easily beats out the Superveloce in terms of power. It does actually weigh slightly more than the regular Speed Triple 1200 RS, So it's like 1 kilogram heavier, but yeah, it's certainly a faster motorcycle than the Superveloce. Now, out of these bikes we've looked at so far, these are the first ones that are actually styled similarly. I would say that the Speed Triple RR had to have been influenced in at least some way by the Superveloce. Very few companies have went with this retro aesthetic for a sport bike. In fact, Superveloce was probably the first one to do it in a very long time, and then now the RR is the second one. So for me, the Superveloce is a more intentional design, a more sort of dedicated, interesting design, whereas the RR just feels like the Speed Triple with a half fairing put on it. Both are beautiful. I do really like the Speed Triple RR. I'm not saying, you know, it isn't cool, because it definitely is. It's one of the coolest sort of styles, you know, that we've seen from Triumph. But for me, the Superveloce is one of the boldest, most interesting motorcycle designs of the past decade or more. It's certainly one of the more beautiful motorcycles that have been made in a while, so I have to give it to MV here. Now for options, the Superveloce wins in terms of paint schemes at the very least. You've got the limited edition Alpine, although that is sold out, but even without the Alpine, you've got 3 paint schemes, the 2 available with sort of the regular Superveloce, and then you have the S, which is amazing, the white with the brown seat. But the Triumph is again going to have more accessories available that you can add sort of through configuration. So to me, I feel like this is a tie. They probably have about the same amount of options, just with you being able to spec up the RR. All right, last we have the price. And here again, of course, Triumph is going to be a bit more affordable. It's not as drastic as some of the other bikes. The RR is quite expensive at 20 grand, but the cheapest Superveloce will run you about 24,000. And of course, you're getting more performance from the Triumph. So this is one of the biggest complaints I think people have with the Superveloce, is that it does need something other than that 800cc engine. Maybe it should have a 1000cc engine or something. And yeah, it'd be nice if it produced like 180 horsepower, especially for the premium you're paying. You kind of should be getting a bigger, faster bike than what you're getting. So yeah, Triumph wins on price. And for this last bike, Triumph wins in my opinion just barely. Again, it depends on what you want out of a bike, but for the most part, you're getting significantly more for your dollar if you go with the Triumph. So again, without intending to, we have a tie between these two companies. MV has a better Hyper Naked or Street Fighter platform. I think Triumph has a better Retro Sport, and it's really close when it comes to the Street Naked. Both of these companies are making probably the best sort of naked sport bikes in the world. And yeah, I really didn't mean for this to happen with these tying. It just sort of happened as I looked through all this stuff. I think it comes down to two main things when you're looking at these companies: design and price. Triumph is always going to be more affordable, and listen, Triumph makes awesome high quality bikes. It's not like you're comparing Honda and MV Agusta. Triumph does have an attention to detail that most companies don't have, but MV Agusta is an exotic Italian brand with an insane reputation for design and detail, and they just win on that front. So the question is, how big is your wallet and how much do you care about owning something really rare and special? So if you don't care about that, I would go with the Triumph. They're still really special bikes, but if you're a bit more of an enthusiast, then I would say MV is probably the way to go, and you can get an affordable MV Agusta these days. You don't have to spend 40 grand. You can spend quite a bit less, especially if you look around. Yeah, the biggest thing also though is service and support. So that's a factor, especially if you're in the United States. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this and thanks for watching. Make sure to watch the other video where I compare Ducati and MV Agusta, and let me know which brands you'd like me to pit versus each other for the next video. And you can do that in the comments below. Until next time, ride safe.